Okay, so now the serve weight will now be added to this. This is my DL1, which is my serve weight, as you can see. So I'll just come downwards here and come back to my load definition. So surface load will be added to surface load, and I'll give it a value of let's say this is then just put it to 0.3. I hit an add, and then I might decide to apply to each and every one here. Select similar position. Click on the counter. Okay, you turn on your panel interiors, turn it on. So after you turn it on, you just click on it and you can select similar by thickness, just by thickness, and just come here and drop this 118 to 143. Gonna apply. So we have it defined, but you should notice the load is defined acting upwards, it's supposed to be acting downward. So what I'll just do is, it was a mistake, you come here, you edit and you put minus sign and hit enter. So all loads are now acting in the right direction. So now the next load I'm about to add is the life load. So the life load is only meant to act on the roof fully. So now you can turn your panel number. Turn it down. This is panel 125, 124, 123, 122, 121, 128, 130. Yeah, like that. Oh, you can put it off and select it one after the other like that. 135. Okay, don't worry if you are selecting the bars, not as much as you are selecting the panel, which is of our major concern here. So just do what is known as copy, Control C, then you come back here to your load definition. You come back to your surface load, then you click on this panel, and then on this panel again you give it a life load of 0.75. you make sure this is changed to your life load, then you click on add, then you can Control V, then click on apply. So that is it. So you can close, then you come to your wind. Then from the wind you can go back here and change it to wind. Then come to your loads, which is manual combination. If you want, close, loads, loads, automatic combination, manual combination, generate more, and took out this oscillation, and then this is okay. Connect, and then we can generate generated load case. Just generate. Yeah, we have 20. Okay. I come to your wind. Go to your loads. Put your window simulation generating load. And click on this. Most of time. Let's generate. And then the wind velocity should be 36. Click on start. And you rest your back to generate the wind load automatically. So to simulate and generate. Is meshing. Now the wind is blowing from this direction. You can see this is it. You see the reaction to take time, take a little bit of time, wait. This is the load acting in this direction. Okay, hit an okay, then I'll close. Then if you should notice here, the load case will regenerate and the window simulation will not be added to it. So I have to remove the load case and regenerate again for the wind. So go to loads. Okay, I can delete from here first. Let me delete all previously edited case. Oh god, that is a mistake. So I want to take out the combination. I want to remove the combination which starts from SLS, SLS and the ULS. I'll leave the wind out of this. I'll go again. Okay, so this is the load case. So I'll go back to my loads. Automatic combination. I decide to choose this but it's not available and you know, it's not available. Loads, automatic combination. Okay, this is available. I want this. Okay. Yeah, I need this. And this. I'll just pick some. I don't want to generate everything now. But you can likewise stick out everything. And okay. So, go back to your geometry. analysis calculation by clicking on this calculator button. Then to load, watch. If you have any error, to tell you. If you have any warnings, to pop up, then investigate. So, I don't know, let's watch. So it has been analyzed and the green button symbolized. So now the next thing to do is come to design, okay, result, then diagram for bars, and to check MY reactions, parameters, text, field, applied, and then this is 2B. So I'll minimize, I'll bring it to the top. I only want to highlight a pattern to check how my load is. So I'll be looking from the front view. I'll be looking from the front view. I have 301, 4461, 431. Okay, I want to align this part here. This is the center part. That's 1.6. Then I'll isolate it into a special view and I'll bring it back up. Then for us to see, I'll click on the section shape. And this is it. This is serious. Okay. So now I'll hit on escape for us to see properly. Is it? What I'll do now is I want to look at, okay, is it global stream? So, okay, differentiated and okay. So at this point here we have 372. Okay. And the other point here we have 325. Okay. And then this is it. This is the decline point, nearby. And we're gonna break our bars into two. And this two colors and go to us here. And we're gonna apply the formation and apply, close. I'll click on exit. Okay. So I'll bring it back. I'll come to design, steel member design. So I can run this first now to calculations first. You can run it first to see any message go before I decide to set other parameters. Okay, these are just my preliminary sections and okay. So I'll click on close, cancel. I'll hit here to group, then I'll go to new, or I can make a new from this previous guy and just edit the name. Then cancel. And then cancel. Okay. So let me check the simple bar properties and yes. I'll come to new, then I'll call this my rupture, then click on this, click on OK, click on this, click on OK. Click on at the top. No flaws. up offline, I'll take care. To come up, define manual. All things I have these, I'll just take out point where elements are joined to this bar. Then the rafter has been created, I will just click on this bar, this is our rafter, click on yes, I'll pick on it, I'll do what is known as select similar by cross section, so it has been highlighted, I'll drop it and apply, okay, then I'll come back again, I'll click on my color. Same properties, and then let's go back on just to finish it. Then the trust, go to my OK and just take on console. I don't need to check for anything, console. And I want to consider some security things to close. Select the middle by cross section, drop apply. And what is known as clone and group. So group list is name. Section. Let me give it a name first. Let me call it column because I want to use save materials for the color, and then for the member list I have to pick one, and I have to pick one. paste. Do Control C, you copy it from this part, remove this one, and do Control V. Then the section you want to choose is UK beams, and which is UB. So but I don't need from this guy lower. I want to select from 300 upwards. Just pick anyone, hit on shift. So then you hit and delete. So we move left with this. So to pick anyone from this guy here, just to control. Okay. So these are the selected sections. You click on OK. Then you click on Save. Then you can always click on OK. But now we'll make another member, which will be called number 2. It will be called our rafter. Okay. Rafter. Then you click on. For the rafter, you go just go to select similar. Yes. Similar by cross section. You copy, Control C, you go to your member list, Control A, you paste. Then case section. You see, UB. So still the same selected section, but I can still remove some if I feel like this section. It's gone. Okay. Then you click on save. Then new. We'll call this struct. Okay. Select similar by cross section. Control C. You paste it here. Control V. Section. This is this drugs. Okay, section. This SHS. So, for this SHS. Okay. This is the problem. Selection. Okay, so that's change. So, okay. For the trust, I don't want from this place downwards here. I don't want anything below 100. I don't want anything below 100. Then hit on this section. Click on OK. So the last one, click on new, call it prison. By cross section. Thank you. Okay. So come here to code group verification list. It's all created. Click on close. Group design. Okay. ULS list. This is not my ULS. My ULS is my combination. I want it from this place to this place. Okay. Loading. Okay, so robot has changed my bar and used the appropriate one for it. Has really changed it. And okay, so I'll just click on change all. Now click on close. Click on cancel. I'll run my calculation again. That's changed everything, as you can see. Everything has now been changed. So all member has now been reduced for us, and I'll just click on my section shape for us to see. So if you notice, it has changed everything, even for this. Yeah, it's what. Okay, I said is to choose this SHS earlier on. That's why I'm having this under boundary SHS. Okay. So okay. I can run these calculations if I feel like. Okay. So this should have worked, but the utility ratio is 1.05. So you check is 1.05, and we have that for 0.88, and then this is too much, which is 0.62, is too low, so choose this instead. We have that of 1 point, so that's why I have to go for this 457 and the equal angle also. So I'll just click on it, has already changed, and okay, I chose both equal angle and this for this. I'll just click on close and cancel, and then for my SLS verification I can just go to my combination and just choose the DSLS, just hit on shift and I'll push it up and click on close, and I'll just run my calculations and wait. So this is it. to look at the results. It passed, and you can list the conclusion on console. And console also. And okay. Let me quickly run through the connections. Okay. So you come to your design. See connection design. To pop up. And robot can determine the connection itself by just picking two member and just hitting on this new connection for selected bars. And for example, let's make a connection for this and just click on this. Come up. Okay, so for example, to make a connections of this UB to this guy here, you can highlight the node, or then you come here to your new connection, or if you know your connection type, new connection, okay. First, let me save my structure first, okay. Okay, let me define a new connections. I'll come here, I'll click on new. Set other properties if you want and just apply and connect and check the connection view. This is it. Then power your calculations, calculate, and that is it. Okay. So this is a frame new, it recognizes it automatically. Then you can check and edit anything you feel like. It all depends on you. Just click on apply and click on OK. And then you run your calculation to check to see if it is fine. So that you have the notes which you can put on Word and on Excel, and you can also have your connection view at the top of the notes, or you can create any connection you want using this. And okay.